Just before we move on to the next section of this course, let's just do a little bit of admin here. Let's create a new commit and make some changes that are necessary based upon the changes that we've made in this section. So we want to make sure that we aren't saving anything that we don't need to into our source control. Now, we did add some new files here and folders when we created and worked with coverage. So we do want to avoid, I think we added in our gitignore, HTML cov. So we want to make sure we avoid adding that to source control, HTML cov. And then in addition to that, we can see that there's a coverage file here that's generated. So we want to not include that in our source control. And then in addition to that, I've added some files here, which you will find in the code source repository connected to these tutorials, the commands and VS Code, but I don't want to add them to source control. So I'm going to use star for any text and then .md, and that's going to avoid any saving any MD files into my source control. So in addition to that, we will also be saving this cache. We don't want to do that. So we don't need to add the cache files into source control. So let's just add that in there. So that avoids that. And let's go back now to GitHub Desktop and take a look. So it does look as though it's still trying to include this folder. So make sure that we get rid of those. So the problem we got here is that because we've only just added the PyCache to our gitignore, the previous PyCache has been saved to our repository. Now, using the command prompt, that's pretty simple to get rid of, but I don't actually remember how to do that in GitHub Desktop. So probably the easiest way at this point is just to follow some of these here. So it looks like we've got JBlogger settings. So if I go into my djblogger and then let's go over to settings. Well, let's just fold down because it's getting hard to find. Djblogger settings. Let's just go ahead and delete this folder. Move that to trash. Let's go back to here. So it looks like we are now removing that. And then here we got tests. So inside of our tests, looks like some cache. Let's get rid of that. Essentially, we can do that with commands. You basically just re-add everything again and it will remove them. But we've just kind of done that manually. I'm not too sure if there is a way through GitHub Desktop to do that. But with that done, let's create a new commit. Let's push to origin. Okay.